No one wants to see curvy women. The controversial words of designer Karl Lagerfeld. He reacted to an ongoing push for more natural-looking women in fashion magazines. But his words only make model Emme more determined. She's a plus-sized model and body image advocate. Known as the world's first full-figured supermodel, she has a large following among women around the world. And her message is pretty clear.
I do get acknowledgement from women who are size 6, size 2, and size 22 for standing up and being at peace with my shape as well as my life.
Yeah.
And not giving in.
Emme uses her profile to change our standards of beauty. She also has a high-fashion collectible doll sculptured in her likeness. Born in New York and raised in Saudi Arabia, her cause connects women around the world. The model Emme is our connector of the day.
She is, and I spoke to her earlier. She's addressing the Sundance Film Festival in the United States. That's where I picked her up in Utah. That's where I found her in Utah today and asked her what her message is.
All of us have to get involved with becoming more aware of what the eating is, exercise, public policy with commercials and what we see, those portion sizes in restaurants, breakdowns of the fat content, the salt content, all that in menus. There needs to be just not one individual and, pills to come out and say, on an individual basis, you need to lose weight.
Sure.
This is what you need to take. That doesn't work. We already know that.
Let's get on to some of these viewer questions. Sarah says, what are your goals and how did you get to where you are now? I mean,
make women realize that they're born into the bodies that they're born into. And if we don't have a point of reference of acceptance, we'll never take good care of ourselves. So if we're always on the hamster wheel of feeling inadequate, we're not going to be the best that we can be and make the right decisions. So every job that I try and take on is to try and increase good body image and self-esteem.
So many of our male viewers, including a guy called John F., said that they actually prefer curvy women. Do you think the pressure to be thin comes primarily from females then rather than from males? It's an interesting question.
I think that the pressure that we put on ourselves, yes, it's self-imposed. However, I think that it's backed up quite a bit with advertising of certain products that want to make us feel that we're not this perfect look that doesn't really exist to sell a product. And that's one of the reasons why I'm speaking here at Sundance.
Edit Effiom asks, how were you brought up and why did you choose to become a supermodel instead of something else? Emme?
I was brought up in a family where dieting was very much a way of life. The size of our bodies, the size of the portions of the food on our plates, related to the hierarchy within the family. If I was very, very hungry, being a young athlete, I had to ask for seconds, but sometimes didn't get them because it wasn't appropriate. And that caused disordered eating. I found that sometimes the portions even went to my father, the larger portions, when it just didn't make sense. It just a very strange way of living. The weight on the scale determined if we were being good that day or bad that day. And quite frankly, I revolted. I chose to get involved in modeling, not kicking and screaming, but I saw that there was an industry that was just beginning in the early 90s called full figured modeling at the Ford Modeling Agency. And I walked in and, I was told to go there. Within about a year, year and a half, I started working pretty regularly. And then I went to a shoot. And this one particular shoot changed the way that I saw my mission in life. And the photographer came in and took one look at me, being almost 6 foot, size 12, very athletic, and said, I'm not shooting this fatty. And it took everything for me not to say, okay, get down and do 100 push-ups, and I bet I could beat you. So I thought there was something seriously wrong. And having a background as a reporter, I said, there's a big story here, and beauty certainly does come in many different arrays of color, as well as many different shapes.
Given what you've just said, a question from Anne here, who says, could you still recommend, after what you've experienced and seen after all of these years, for, say, your own daughter to go into modelling, or would you steer her away from that as a career?
interestingly enough, my daughter is very tall for her age, and she's really got some beautiful looks to her. She doesn't have to prove to myself or her father that she's beautiful. And although people say to her all the time, you should go into acting, you should go into modeling, I want her to run around and roll around in the mud with her friends and skin her knees and you know, have the free life of a child and have a childhood. If she wants to act, if she wants to get involved with the industry in which I'm a part of, I want her to be much older. Mm. That's just plain and simple. I want her to have a childhood.
And finally, a question from Louise. Who do you admire most in the fashion industry and why?
I've always enjoyed Cindy Crawford. She always had a shapely body. When we worked together for Revlon, I just enjoyed her effervescence, the way that she led her life. She put her family first. She worked very, very hard. And she always had a shape. I believe that the supermodels of the 90s seemed to have more curviness. Not that they were role models, but those are the women that I grew up with.